A few days ago, AMD released a new driver that had one pretty important change. This change is OpenGL optimizations. This driver has actually been in testing for a little bit, but after encountering a few bugs, I decided to hold off on further testing until the driver fully released. But now that the full release is there, I've gone and tested a few games and emulators. In a changelog, AMD claims up to 79% performance uplift in Minecraft. That is running at maximum setting and 4K. But if every application has even half the benefit of Minecraft, this is still a really good improvement. Obviously, due to testing and hardware difference, my results are probably going to differ a little bit, but that testing still gives an idea of what to expect. This isn't the first optimization AMD has done recently. However, this one actually works on every GPU supported by the driver, rather than only the latest GPUs available. The test system is an i5-12400F, a Vega 56, and 8GB of RAM in dual channel. Before going into the results, I just want to mention that the regular drivers are still absolutely unusable with my Vega 56. It crashed multiple times during testing and just made it a pain overall. This is why instead of the latest drivers, I will be testing it against 22Q2, which is the latest Pro driver version. The first game I've tested is Doom 2016. I don't own the game, so I had to use the demo. As a result, the version may be a little outdated. The game refused to work with Vulkan, so I won't be able to compare it to that, but we can still notice improvements in OpenGL performance. The Pro driver performed fairly well, running the game at an average of 153fps, and the 1% loads were of 81, while the new driver had an average of 166fps and 1% of 83. The 1% loads didn't really improve much on this game, but the average still did see a nice difference. OpenMW saw a pretty nice difference in average, but also in 1% lows, with a difference of 20 and 40fps. The old driver had an average of 226, and the new one an average of 250, while the 1% lows were of 141 and 186. 7 Days to Die ran pretty poorly using the old driver, and it completely refused to run using OpenGL on a new driver, so I guess there's a bug somewhere, whether it's the game or the driver. I still tested Vulkan and DirectX 11 as well, and out of the two, only DirectX 11 actually launched the game. Using the old driver and OpenGL, the game ran an average of 40fps and 1% lows of 35, and using DirectX 11, an average of 98 and 1% of 36. Wolfenstein The New Order. This game was locked at 60fps originally, and unlocking it is really hard. Using console commands, the game just speeds up really fast. There is a mod that keeps the game in sync, but it doesn't work with the Epic version by default. After some searching, I found someone that modified the DLL, and so I had to modify the hex values within the mod. If anyone needs it, I'll try to put the tutorial down in the description. Now the game is mostly okay, but it's still a few animations that are really sped up. The old driver on average ran the game at 178fps and the new one did 212, while the 1% lows were of 125 versus 167. Amnesia The Dark Descent did not see much improvement in the average, but the 1% lows did have quite the improvement. The averages were of 196 and 203, while the 1% lows were of 97 versus 146. This game is also locked to 60fps by default, and unlocking the frame rate kinda makes some effects freak out. But whenever I've played from the game at an unlocked frame rate, it does seem playable, at least in the beginning. Subnautica by default is a DirectX 11 game, but being a Unity game, you can force it to launch in OpenGL through the launch options, and the improvement in that game is quite nice. The old driver had an average of 1% of 109 and 37, while the new one has 142 average, and 1% of 80. That's a nearly 40fps improvement and almost doubling the 1%. It now performs pretty much like DirectX 11, which runs at an average of 142 and 1% of 87. Killing Floor has some really great results, with the old driver having an average of 95 and 1% of 58, and the new one having an average of 450 and 1% of 242. I also compared it to DirectX 9, which had an average of 295 and 1% of 212, making OpenGL superior using the new driver. And next is Minecraft. I had some weird results with that game, so I went and tested multiple times, in pretty different ways. I started by benchmarking the game at 20 chunk render distance fancy settings. The benchmark consisted of being on a minecart and going from point A to point B without moving the camera. This way was done 3 times in a row for each benchmark. The old driver was pretty consistently better than the new one, with averages of 436, 1% of 160, and the new one having averages of 355 and 1% of 152. I lowered the runner distance to 8 chunk and ran through the same benchmark 3 times once again. And the difference was still here. The old drivers did 1040 and 295, while the new one did 986 and 403. The 1% was significantly better this time, but the average was still below. So I tried to make the camera angle a little more consistent, and ran through the benchmark 3 times again. This time the old driver did 1268 FPS average and 1% of 340, while the new one did 1233 and 1% of 512. At such high frame rates, the average is probably closer to margin of error, so the very slight difference shouldn't really matter anyway, but it's still about 30 frames below. At this point, I thought that maybe there were some streaming issues with the driver or something, so I decided to do another benchmark and have a static camera this time. The player did not move and no chunk was being loaded during the benchmark. This time the old driver had an average of 736 and 1% of 257, while the new driver had an average of 916 and 1% of 446. So the moving benchmark consistently had a lower average frame rate, although the 1% could be a little better. I also briefly could not test Minecraft without testing shaders, but the performance was pretty much the same between the two, with both drivers being around 33 FPS average and about 21% lows. I've tested a bunch of emulators, but before that, let's look at a benchmark. Uningine Heaven ran at 72 FPS average, and using the new driver, it ran at an average of 87 FPS. I also tested DX11, which ran at 81 FPS. Minimum framerate wise, the Pro driver did 11 FPS, the new driver did 16, and the DX11 did 30. Starting the emulators with Citra. Pokémon Sun, unlocking the framerate and allowing the game to run really, really fast. The old driver did 86 average and 61%, while the new one did 142 average and 91%. I had to use a custom build because the new driver crashes Citra every time I launch a game, but the fix should be merged soon enough, hopefully. I've also tried the Binding of Isaac, but new 3DS emulation is still not really good, so I'll just leave the results on screen and move on. Next up is Cemu. I've tested Zelda Breath of the Wild, and the old driver cannot even reach the frame cap. The averages were 20 and 30, and the 1% were 12 and 13. The ryujinx, a Nintendo Switch emulator. I've tested only Mario Kart 8 on it, since that's the only game I own, and the openmw driver cannot hit the frame cap. The averages were 32 versus 60, and the 1% was 17 versus 35. And finally, here's a PC at 3. OpenGL is still somewhat broken on this emulator, so no matter the driver, there will be some graphical issues. Like GTA 5 that looks like you're in a dream, or maybe high on some sort of drug. But you know what's not high? The framerate. Using the old driver, the average framerate was 9 FPS, and the 1% lows were 4 FPS, while the new driver runs at 26 FPS average and 7 1%. Using Vulkan, those numbers go up to 30 and 20, and the graphics are much less broken, though still not perfect. And then finally, I've tested The Last of Us. The graphics are mostly slightly broken using OpenGL, but they broke differently using the new driver, with more effects displaying, but the characters were flickering pretty much every color. The average using the old driver was 18 FPS, and the 1% were 9 FPS, while the new driver was 27 and 17. Comparing it to Vulkan, it still gets 30 FPS average and 21 1%. Overall, those new drivers are massive improvements over the previous ones. The most mainstream programs run really well and have really big improvements. In some cases, OpenGL is even worth using over other APIs, though in others, it breaks compatibility. So if you play anything using OpenGL, you should probably update to this new driver. That is if your system does not crash every 10 seconds using that driver.